This video is about making position time graphs. Position time graphs show an object's position on the y-axis and the time on the x-axis. They're used to show complicated motion on a simple picture. So as an example, this graph represents the position of an object after a certain amount of time has passed. So I'm going to drop an object here, a person, and I'm going to say that this person is starting at a position of 3. So when no time has passed yet, they're at a position of 3. So that would mean that my y-intercept of the graph when time is equal to 0 is going to be a position of 3. I'm now going to allow time to pass, and you're going to observe how that affects the position graph as the person moves. So you can see that they moved from a position of 3 to a position of 6, and it took them 3 seconds. So that means they're moving up one unit of position for every second that passes. And you can see that's reflected on the graph. For every 1 second that passes, they're up another one unit of position on the graph. For this next part of the graph, they're going to be stopped. And this is what that looks like. You can see they're just staying at the same position as the time passes. Now they'll move like this. And then like this. So I'm going to have you watch a few of these and begin to pick up on any patterns that you notice in how the graph works. Here's another example. So we're just going to observe how the person moves and watch what it does to the position time graph. Okay, now that you've had a few examples of those graphs, I'm going to play an animation and have you try to guess what the graph is going to look like for this specific animation. So I'm going to start this person off at a position of 2 and then run the clock. And I'm going to play this a few times so you have a chance to draw this in your notes and see if you can guess what the position time graph will look like. So we're going to start now. And I can replay that one more time. Okay, here's the answer. This is what it's going to look like. They're starting at a position of 2, so that means that the y-intercept of the graph is going to be at 2. They then move up at 1 meter for every second that passes until they get to a position of 6. Then they stop for 5 seconds, and then they move down at 2 units of position for every second until they're at a position of 0 at 12 seconds. So that's what that graph would look like. We can now begin to pick up on patterns in these graphs. The first one you might have noticed is that the y-intercept of a position time graph is the starting position of the object. This is always true because by definition, the y-intercept is what the y-value is doing when the x-value is 0. So here, this is what is the position doing when the time is 0, which is the starting position of the object. The slope of the graph is equal to the velocity of the object. The reason why this is the case is because if you look at the rise and the run, I can see that the rise is the change in position, which is the displacement, and the run is the change in time. And because slope is rise over run, I can rewrite that as the displacement over the time, which is equal to the velocity. So this will always be true. The slope of the position time graph is always going to be equal to the velocity because of this definition. So I can look through this graph here and just observe what's happening. For this first section, I can see that this person is moving at 1 meter per second because they have a slope of 4/4, a rise of 4 meters and a run of 4 seconds. So their velocity is 1 meter per second. So for every 1 second, they travel exactly 1 meter. In this next section, I can see that this is just a flat line, so the position is not changing at all. So that means that the slope is 0/5, which is just 0 meters per second. And that means that their velocity is 0. And you could see also that they weren't moving in that period of time. They were just standing still, so they have a velocity of 0. For this last section, I can see that they're moving down -6 meters in 3 seconds. So that means that their velocity here is -2 meters per second, 6 divided by 3. And I can see here also that when they move down, they're moving down 2 meters for every 1 second that passes. So that's a really important pattern in position time graphs that we can use to help us draw and interpret them. Here's an example problem. What is the starting position of this object and what is the velocity of this object? Well, the starting position is pretty easy. That's just the y-intercept. So that's just going to be 2 meters. The velocity is a little bit more difficult. We just need to take the slope for that. So the run here is 12 seconds. The rise is 3 meters. So the slope is going to be 3 meters divided by 12 seconds, which is equal to 0.25 meters per second. So that would be the velocity of the object on this position time graph. We can also determine the starting position of this object and also determine the velocity at 2 seconds, the velocity at 6 seconds, and the velocity at 10 seconds. The starting position here is 4. That's pretty simple. I'm now going to look up at what's going on at 2 seconds. And I can see here that the line that this is on has a run of 4 seconds and a rise of 2 meters. So that means that the slope at that point is 2 meters over 4 seconds, which is equal to 0.5 meters per second. Over here, this line I can see is perfectly flat, so that means that the slope is just 0. It's 4 seconds long, but it's not going up or down at all, so it's 0/4. So the velocity there is 0 meters per second. Finally, at a time of 10, I can see that this line that it's on has a run of 4 and a rise of -6. So I plug those in and I get a velocity of -1.5. So that's how you would find the velocity at different times for an object on a position time graph. This next section is about how to find the distance and displacement on a position time graph. To find the distance, you're just going to add up all the individual distances that this object travels along its path. And to find the displacement, you're just going to compare the beginning and final points that the object is at. So you can see for this object that they're going up 4 meters. And then they're standing still. And then they're going down 6 meters like this. So the total distance here would be 4 + 0 + 6. So the total distance would be 10 meters. And the displacement, we just have to compare the beginning and ending points. So they're ending at a position of 0 and they started at a position of 2. So their displacement is just going to be -2 meters specifically. That's how you find the distance and displacement on a position time graph. Here's another example. What is the distance the object traveled after 7 seconds? And what is the displacement it traveled after 7 seconds? So let's compare those two. I can see that the total distance traveled here is going from 1 to 7. So that's a distance of +6. It then stays still, so we don't add any distance there. And then it goes down to 7 seconds. So I can see that it traveled another 5 meters. So the total distance it traveled was 11 meters. The displacement is just the straight line length from where it started to where it stopped. So it started at a position of 1, ended at a position of 2. So the displacement is +1 meters.